of reaching the finals of the Suzuki Cup. Let's get details from TJ Manotok, who now joins us on the line from Singapore. Go ahead, TJ.
Hi, Tina. Yes, well, the Azkals unfortunately failed to advance to the finals. They were so close, as you've been mentioning throughout the last couple of days. After the scoreless draw in Manila on Saturday, the Azkals only needed at least a scoring draw, meaning at least a 1-1 draw, to advance to the finals. But they could not find the back of the net today. It was Singapore who was the one who was able to score early on off a tricky play on a free kick that really caught the Azkals defense by surprise and flat-footed. And there was nothing to stop that strong goal by Mohamed Ambi, which was early enough to put a lot of pressure on the team of the Philippines. And in the second half, the Philippines was indeed more aggressive offensively, but still Singapore, with that 1-0 lead in the second half, they were able to have the luxury of sitting back and playing more defensively to protect that lead. And that's exactly what happened. They hardly had any attempts on the offensive end. The Philippines had several tries to bring the ball forward, to bring the ball in. Chichi Caligong was a key substitute in the half, but he came and gave a lot of aggressiveness and creativity offensively, but all for naught as the Philippines drops out of the tournament. But then again, you know, we've been talking to some Philippine media here and putting it in perspective. This is an improvement from 2010, wherein we were the surprise semifinalists in 2010. This year, we were expected to battled it out, and really wouldn't be surprising if we made the semis, but now we're here and we've had a better result compared to last time around. In 2010, we lost to two matches against Indonesia, both 1-0. This time around, a 0-0 draw against Singapore and a 1-0 loss. So as Coach Vice mentioned in the post-game press conference, he said that you know, it is obviously disappointing to lose this match having been so close, but he as well said, putting it in perspective, that there's obviously an improvement in the Philippine side, and he hopes that come January, when they get back together again to prepare for the AFC Challenge Cup, which happens in March, and the elimination group stages will actually be hosted in Manila. They're hoping for a better result there and hope to bounce back and hope that the experience from getting deep into this tournament again will carry their momentum onto their tournaments next year. Yeah.
Thank you so much, TJ Manotok there in Singapore.